Has it been tough for you as a writer to know all of the things you know about story development and writing and being able to incorporate it? Like, you know what I mean? Is it difficult?
No, because I think half of it is emotion and knowing where your characters want to go, and a lot of it, and half of it's craft.
Like, yeah.
I mean, my main pressure was making sure I didn't put out a whack book. Like, I mean, because if I, like, as editor-in-chief, if I put out a horrible book, then
people will now never listen to your
edits. It's possible.
Edits, you know what I mean?
Even, like, well, that's what Robert said. Robert's like, he read it, he goes, you can give me notes from time to time now if you want.
Oh, so nice.
It took writing his own book. I haven't taken him up on that offer. But that was a compliment.
Hey, what's going on, people? It me, Ian Stard.
And it me, Hector Navarro.
We're here for a very special reason. Well, I'm always here.
Right.
But Hector, why are you here?
I'm here because Skybound's very own Sean Makowitz has a new book that released this week titled Gasolina. By Skybound's very own, I mean Skybound's editor-in-chief, who oversees the creation of all the beautiful comics that you love. To celebrate, we sat Sean down in a chair mere feet behind where we're standing and talked about stuff like how he got into the comic book industry, some of his influences, what it's like being an editor and a writer, and even love.
Hey guys, we're here with Skybound editor-in-chief Sean Makowitz, and we got a whole mess of questions for him, so let's get into it. Let's talk about your new book that you are writing.
Yeah.
Gasolina, give us the pitch for Gasolina.
The pitch is basically what happens when the Mexican drug wars turn supernatural. So
it's a great pitch.
So we focus on Randy and Malia, who are two newlyweds who have criminal backgrounds, and they become embedded in this new war and have to become freedom fighters against the cartels and all the crazy shit that they get up to.
Yeah, and then you said that there's a supernatural element to it as well. How do you find the balance between, like you said, like some real serious subject matter? This is stuff that's not necessarily fun to read about.
No.
But how do you find that balance between that sort of realistic world versus the supernatural that you're adding into the story?
Well, I think, you know, embedding with this couple and rooting for people that are on the ground floor helping out these towns and villages caught in the crossfire. By the end of it, once you embrace this relationship, the supernatural stuff starts coming in. And over the course of the first five issues, that sliding scale of crime to horror, it starts going completely downhill. So by issue five, it's just full-blown horror with some crime elements.
Cool. Dressing,
yeah.
Where did you come up with the idea for Gasolina?
I've been interested in the narco drug wars for a while, and is to educate myself. And it kind of came out of the question of, you know, they're committing mega murder down there, and just coming up with horrible ways to keep killing people, and my brain went to what else could they do?
Yeah,
and it
as
really
it
was.
Normally does. That's kind of messed up a little bit. Yeah.
No, I fully own that is not a good place to live at, which is why finding people that could combat that and take a stand against that was really where I wanted to go. But it was sort of find that supernatural angle, and then it was kind of once I started doing my research on the history of Mexico more. Mm-hmm. And the current situation, there was a lot of odd dovetails. Like, I didn't know much about Veracruz, and I was like, it's a place I haven't seen many stories take place, but it's also the place where cartels landed, and that's where the Spanish started their invasion and conquering of the Aztec Empire.
Interesting.
So once that started clicking in, it became a little bit more real.
What has it been like to see the art from Nico Walter coming in?
It's great. I mean, he was a guy that I had met at WonderCon years ago. He just showed me his portfolio. I was busy at the time. I was like, hey, why don't you come back? Like, hoping that he would never come back.
Yeah.
And then he came back exactly what, like, on the minute, and I opened it up and I was like, oh, no, don't go anywhere.
Yeah.
And so we hired him to do a book called Demonic. He did six issues of that, and that was really his first published work. And see how he worked as a storyteller, and I just love his storytelling. I think his shot selection and panel-to-panel work is just amazing. He knows how to set a tone as well.
Yeah.
So yeah, once we finished Demonic, and this was kind of percolating, he was my first choice. And I had talked to him, I said, what do you want to do? And he was like, something with ancient civilizations, or he wanted something that's a little bit more period, and he's like, also monsters. And I was like, well, how about we take all that stuff and we put it in modern day?
But want monsters also kind of, yeah.
So, the monsters, we'll get to that. But yeah. And also his yeah, he was designing cool creatures in Demonic, so yeah, he's just a fantastic talent. I didn't want to let him go.
Another thing that's so great about his art in Gasolina is a lot of the times, I mean, most of the time, artists, their job is also to sort of be the directors when it comes to getting performances out of the characters, mm-hmm. the acting.
Yeah.
They have to draw good acting.
Yeah.
And the acting in the book good. By the characters is fantastic. The, yeah. the expressions of the characters are so great and so realistic and so nuanced and so subtle and yeah, so he's so good at that.
Yeah, there's a moment in issue four that asks him for Randy to deliver a Denzel smile, the smile where it's like, I'm gonna kill you, uh-huh. but I'm gonna smile about it first. And yeah, he does that, so it's fun. I mean, he definitely
that's great.
Takes those characters to a new level.
What have you learned in your very long career as an editor mm-hmm. that you're bringing to your writing? What have you learned that you're incorporating is in you as a writer?
I think especially since coming to Skybound, a focus on character, making sure that readers have something to really latch on to. It's really that emotional undercurrent, that arc that will carry people throughout. Because you can have a number of twists and turns, which
right.
I definitely, you know, am a strong believer in strong cliffhangers. But unless you care about these characters and have the urgency and the stakes of them living or dying or what have you, then that series is probably going to fail. And I think it's something that readers may not be consciously aware of, but they go, this one just, something doesn't feel right about this.
Yeah.
And we work hard at making sure that our characters are well-rounded and are trying to achieve something. And they don't have to be 100% likable, but you understand why they're doing things and they're intriguing.
How dark are we going to get? How supernatural are we going to get?
I mean, The key is always to make sure it still feels like the real world and not go overboard. So yeah, I mean, by the end of five, there's going to be, you're introduced to some supernatural beings or creatures that you're going to be interested in. And it's going to slowly escalate but you're never going to get ahead of the characters. The characters are always going to be, those supernatural elements will always be introduced by the characters encountering them. In issue three, we introduce you to a cartel boss named El Dorado.
Oh boy.
Who's his own brand of special.
And this is coming from the company that has given us characters like the Governor and Negan. And you know what I mean? For you to go like, this is a real special brand of evil. Like, that's terrifying. That's real messed up.
He is actually a rival that isn't using this new brand of murder. So they try to assassinate him and he doesn't take to it very kindly. So we'll get into that.
Sean, what's your best piece of advice for aspiring writers?
Just keep writing. I mean, it's tough without relying on the same old cliches.
Sure.
But actually putting your story down into a document mm-hmm. and working on something to completion is always just how it starts. It doesn't have to be the best thing. I think mm-hmm. my first drafts are, I'd say like C-, but, and it's probably the editor side of me, is that I can come back to that material, look at it with fresh eyes, and I assess what does and doesn't work. So mm-hmm. I think being honest with that. Yeah, and I think, you know, if you're open to sharing that material with other people and getting their honest opinions, and, you know, I think learning how to take feedback and criticism is definitely a learned thing.
Yeah.
But knowing that hopefully people have the best intentions. Also knowing that you don't have to take every note, because a lot of notes are dumb.
We're just people, yeah.
And also you're coming to it from a different space, but yeah,
sure.
You kind of have to have that two ways of looking at it, as the creator and as someone new to the material.
Yeah. I'm going to put you on the spot. Hit us with three comics that everybody should read.
All right. My go-to right now is Kaiju Max, which is put up by Oni Press by Xander Cannon. It's essentially
cool.
A Supermax prison for Kaiju. But basically filtered through like what it would be like in Oz. Like it's like an Oz prison drama, but with Kaiju. I know it's another popular pick, but I'm also catching up on One Punch Man right now.
Cool,
which,
cool.
The way that you redefine superheroes is having someone from Japan look at how ridiculous and fun.
Yeah.
And just to have a character with the power that he can basically just knock out anyone with one punch is amazing.
Yeah.
But that presents its own difficulties, which is the same thing people have been saying about Superman for years. He can beat anything. Well, One Punch Man can beat Superman.
Yeah.
So I don't know. But
has that fight been done yet?
I don't think so.
Oh man, I'm sure the internet's probably debated about
that. Yeah, maybe. I haven't gone. I don't go
That's
and search
amazing.
Out those
yeah,
discussions.
Yeah, yeah. Who would win in a fight? Yeah.
Mage by Matt Wagner.
Cool.
Was something that felt like an image book when I read the second series when it came out in I think late 90s.
Mm-hmm.
And that's something that's like it's a action magic book, but it's basically Matt Wagner's put so it's almost autobiographical. the point that this character has aged up. And now,
that's cool.
After, I think, being off the stands for almost 20 years, he's finally come to complete this. So I think that fulfillment of personal vision and something that's also has been commercially viable is a tough road to go.
So, I love that. That's cool.
Yeah.
That's great. All right, Sean Mackowitz, I believe you. You wouldn't lead me astray. I really appreciate it. Thank you for talking with us today. This has been fantastic.
Thanks.
And I love you.
Thank you.
And before we get back to it, we recently held a signing at a shop called Quest to celebrate the release of Gasolina, where fans could show their love and pick up the new book signed by Sean himself. So now it's time for all of you who couldn't attend to jump onto our love boat and pick up your copy today. Now, back to Hector and myself.
You know what, Hector? You did a very good job.
Oh, thanks, Ian.
I have something for you.
What?
Brian Mitchell, Skybound artist.
Wait, Brian Mitchell?
The Brian Mitchell. Oh. He's right there on camera.
Oh my gosh.
Created his own variants for our comics, and this is the Gasolina variant from Brian Mitchell.
Can I keep this?
Yeah, sure.
Then that's cool. Thanks, guys.
No problem. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, and become an insider if you aren't already. We have over 20 interviews for you guys to watch. Also, tune into our Twitch streams on Thursday, where we chop it up about our favorite comics of the week, and Fridays for some board and card game fun with big man Mike Falzone. We got a lot going on, guys, so come hang out with us. We'll see you next week.